Did your IVF protocol not go the way you wanted? It's clear that IVF works better if you produce multiple eggs. Fertility medications are required during IVF to stimulate the maturation of multiple eggs in the ovaries. Some medications are used commonly, like those containing FSH. You may have heard, however, that some doctors use growth hormone to stimulate the ovaries. Is this something you should consider? Stay tuned. Hi, if you're new to this channel, I'm Dr. Randy Morris. I'm an IVF expert in the United States and the host of Infertility TV. I give easy to understand, honest, science-based tips that have helped couples all over the world have their rainbow baby. If you want to improve your odds for success, hit that subscribe button right now. It's like having a fertility specialist in your phone. To understand the use of growth hormone in IVF, it's important to first understand how eggs mature in the ovaries. Each egg in the ovaries is surrounded by cells. The egg and the surrounding cells together is called a follicle. Follicle cells have receptors on the surface which react to hormones. As an egg matures, the number of receptors change and the type of receptors change. Before the egg starts maturing, the main type of hormone receptor responds to FSH. FSH injections are critically important during the first several days of stimulating the ovaries. As the egg matures, the follicle enlarges and fills with fluid, and the number of FSH receptors decreases. Larger follicles start to accumulate receptors for LH. Therefore, injections of FSH are less important after the first few days of stimulation. This is why doctors will also use medications that contain LH or hCG, which can both work through those LH receptors. IVF protocols containing FSH and LH, or FSH and hCG, will work adequately to stimulate the ovaries of most women during IVF. Some women, however, don't seem to do very well with these hormones. Some women don't respond very well to fertility medications and only produce a few eggs. Other women produce eggs that seem to be of poor quality and, as a result, don't produce good quality embryos. For patients like these, doctors have looked at using growth hormone as a third medication to stimulate the ovaries. Like FSH and LH, growth hormone is normally produced in the pituitary gland. The follicle cells have receptors for growth hormones, just like they have receptors for FSH and LH. In addition to working directly on growth hormone receptors, growth hormone might also work indirectly by improving how the follicles respond to FSH and LH. IVF doctors have studied whether adding growth hormone to the stimulation protocol would help with some of these problem patients. I'm going to focus on women who don't make very many eggs. Doctors call this group of women poor responders. There has been more research about the use of growth hormone in IVF poor responders than any other group. Recently, an analysis looked at 12 high-quality studies that had been done using growth hormone for IVF poor responders. Here is what they found. IVF poor responders using growth hormone were able to increase the total number of eggs retrieved by about 66%. While this sounds impressive, consider this. By definition, poor responders produce very few eggs. In the studies reviewed, the average number of eggs obtained in IVF cycles without growth hormone was between 4 and 5. With growth hormone, the average was in the 5 to 7 range. So even if growth hormone works for you, you should not be expecting to see a huge difference. Are these extra eggs usable? That brings us to conclusion number 2. The data showed that the extra eggs produced by using growth hormone were mature eggs that could be used to try to fertilize. In fact, the study showed that growth hormone users would average about twice as many mature eggs. That's great. Third, growth hormone increased the number of embryos available for an embryo transfer, but again, it wasn't a lot. There was, on average, less than one extra embryo for transfer. How can you have less than one extra embryo? Remember that we're talking about groups here. If you had a group of 5 women and they all produced an extra embryo, that would be an average of 1 extra embryo for the group. If you had 5 women and 3 produced an extra embryo but the other 2 did not, then the group average would have increased by 0.6, or less than 1 embryo. This is important. It means that not all poor responders will produce more embryos using growth hormone. Finally, this review of available studies did not find that the chance for pregnancy or live birth was higher in the women who used growth hormone. Why not? If growth hormone users produced more eggs, more mature eggs, and had more embryos for transfer, should there have been more pregnancies? It's important to understand that not all of the studies reported pregnancy rates, and even less reported live birth rates. It's possible that there was a benefit to using growth hormone, but the available studies were too small to detect it. It's also possible that growth hormone is simply ineffective at increasing the live birth rate. At this point, we don't know for sure. One final thing to understand about growth hormone before you consider adding it to your IVF protocol. It is expensive. For a single IVF attempt, using growth hormone would add a few thousand dollars in medication costs. Even if you are lucky enough to have IVF insurance coverage, growth hormone still may not be covered. Our Infertility TV bottom line is this. If you are an IVF poor responder, adding growth hormone to your medication protocol may increase the number of eggs, mature eggs, and embryos that you make. A little. Whether it improves your chances for taking home a baby is still uncertain. The cost is high, and it means giving an additional injection to yourself every day. But other than that, there does not appear to be any downside to trying. If you like this video, remember to like this video. If you have an idea for a future episode of Infertility TV, leave it in the comments. Subscribe now. Infertility TV publishes a new episode every week. It's like having a fertility specialist in your phone.